Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll be studying the SDR, that is a software defined radio. Now the software defined radio is basically used to reduce the hardware that are being used at the transmitter and the receiver. These hardwares are nothing but mixers, oscillators, modulators, demodulators, etc. So let us study, why do we require a SDR, that is a software defined radio. Basically, let us try to understand what is the need of the software defined radio. Since there is an increasing demand of the multiple technologies to coexist, that is GSM, IS-136, PDC, etc., it is required that there should be multiple frequency bands that a terminal should work on. Hence, we require a terminal that is able to communicate with all the radio interferences of all these varying technologies. Hence, a person who is working under SDR should be able to understand all these radio interfaces, whether it is for transmission or for multiple access of the system. So, a software-defined radio theory will actually allow all the manufacturers to generate or make the terminals that are independent of any single standard. Means a terminal should be able to communicate with any radio interface of all the systems. A software-defined radio will actually help reduce the hardware that we are using. In this case, it will also reduce the industrial waste that has been created because of this hardware systems. Let us now look at how the software-defined radio looks like and what are the units of this software-defined radio. So there are multiple units which together form the software-defined radio. The first unit is the antenna. Then we have the radio frequency unit. Then we have the intermediate frequency unit. Then we have an analog to digital and a digital to analog converter. Then we have the baseband unit. Then we have transmission control unit. Then we have input output processing unit. And finally we have end-to-end timing control unit. So all these units together form the software defined radio. Let us see the meaning of all these units. Let us come to the first unit, that is the antenna unit. Remember, in the upper side there is written the transmission or the transmitter, whereas in the lower side there is a reception. The signal that is getting transmitted from the end-to-end timing control unit up to the antenna forms the transmitter part of the system, whereas the signal that is going from the antenna towards the end-to-end timing control unit forms the receiver of the system. Whereas the signal that is moving from the antenna towards the end-to-end timing control unit forms the receiver of the system. So let us see first the antenna. So the antenna are actually able to select the performance of the software-defined radio based on the external conditions, that is the traffic and the channel availability. Hence these antennas are called as smart antennas. These antennas are able to automatically select the amount of radio that has been required depending on the external conditions. These smart antennas or the software antennas are able to do multiplexing in terms of SDMA, which is called as space division multiplexing. In this space division multiplexing, the user information is steered towards the user in such a way that the user is divided in space. This system helps the formation of beam, that is called as a beam steering antennas which have been used. Multiple access can be achieved by changing the direction of these beams. Hence, multiple users are able to access the system using the same space that is available. And narrower beams are used in such a way that the interference amongst the users is minimum as possible. Let us now see the next unit, that is the radio frequency unit. In this radio frequency unit, the signal that is coming from the BBU or the IFU, that is the intermediate frequency unit, is up converted to the frequency that is used for transmission. Hence, in this unit, the actual frequency that is required for transmission is been created. This is the transmitter part of the RFU. At the receiver part, when the antenna gives a signal to the RFU unit, this signal is down converted to the frequency that is required for the IFU terminal or the intermediate frequency for processing. The signal at the receiver here is amplified first. That is, inside the RFU unit, the received signal is first amplified to a certain level and then it is given to the IFU unit. At the receiver of the RFU, that is a radio frequency unit, the signal is first amplified, the signal that is coming from the antenna. It is first amplified and then it is down converted to the signal frequency that is required by the IFU unit or the baseband unit. So all the units that are available here have got two parts. One part is for the transmission of the system and the other part is for the reception of the system. The next unit is the IFU unit, which is also called as the intermediate frequency unit. In this intermediate frequency unit, at the transmitter side, the signal from the A to D conversion is given. This signal is amplified and up converted to the intermediate frequency that is required for processing. At the receiver side of the IFU unit, the signal that is received from the antenna is transmitted to the IFU via RFU. The RFU then transmits the signal to the IFU. At IFU, the signal is amplified first. This amplified signal is then down converted to the frequencies that are suitable for using in the A to D conversion. Let us see the next unit, that is the analog to digital conversion unit. At the transmitter side, the BBU, that is a baseband signal, transmits the digital information. But remember, antenna always transmits an analog signal. So here, a D to A converter, that is a digital to an analog converter, is used at the transmitter side, which converts the digital baseband signal to an analog signal. This signal is then transmitted to the IFU and the RFU unit for up conversion of the frequency. At the receiver side of the A to D and the D to A converter, what is done is the analog signal that is received by the antenna is first amplified to a certain level, which is used by the A to D and the D to A converter. Since we require a digital signal at the baseband unit for the signaling purposes, what we do is we use a sampling here to sample the analog signal so that it gets converted to a digital signal. So remember, at the transmission, what we do is we convert the digital signal to an analog signal so that it is compatible for the transmission with the antenna. Whereas at the receiver side, the received analog signal is converted to a digital signal for further processing. The next block that is available to us is the BBU unit, which is called the baseband unit. In this baseband unit, the digital modulation of the signal takes place at the transmitter side. Means the signal is digitally modulated and then sent to the A to D and a D to A converter for further processing. Similarly, at the receiver side, the transmitted signal is received by using the samples that are used in A to D and a D to A converter. The next unit available to us is the transmission control unit. In this transmission control unit, the data bits are formatted depending on the transmission protocol of the MAC layer. Means the bits are transmitted in such a way that there are some error coding protocols been included into that. At the receiver side, this transmission control unit helps check the errors in transmission. If there are errors in transmission, then retransmission is requested from the transmitter. The next unit available to us is input-output processing unit. Remember, since we are using handsets or computers as our devices, all the information is transmitted from these handsets and computers, whereas all the received information is again processed back to these handsets and computers. So the input-output terminal basically controls the input-output of these handsets and devices. The last unit available to us is end-to-end timing processing unit. This end-to-end timing processing unit maintains the time duration between the transmission and the reception of the signals. Now let us see what are the advantages to these commercial providers and the service providers of this software-defined radio. This software-defined radio has helped the service providers in terms of global roaming. Now we can use a single handset and we can use all the multiple generations that are available just because of the software-defined radio. Hence, I may need not change my handset if I'm moving to some other country where some other standards are available for transmission. My handset is capable of adjusting to those frequencies because of the software available. The next advantage is upgradable terminals. I can easily upgrade my terminals at any point of time. New services are added at any given point of time. I need not change the handset again for the services. The next advantage or improvement is bugs can be fixed at any given point of time. If the software is having any bug, a very quick software update will remove all the bugs. And the last advantage is a very versatile software is available to us. Let us see what are the advantages to the various government agencies for the use of this software-defined radio. Various global roaming services can be provided because of the use of this software-defined radio. And the second advantage is the hardware is very much reduced in the software-defined radio, since a single software is able to provide multiple radio interfaces. Let us see what are the advantages for the users. User has an advantage of global roaming. I can roam anywhere using this software-defined radio in the mobile phones. One terminal, many services are available. I can use a single handset for multiple services that are available. New services are provided without having to change the hardware. New services are provided without having to change the terminal itself. And finally, bugs can be fixed with a quick software update for the users as well. And this bug fixing we are seeing in the software that we are using in the smartphones these days, a very quick software update removes all the bugs of the software. So we are able to remove all the bugs of the software. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.